Hi, and thank you for watching and commenting my last video. To now that I have been at the TIG welding pool 2 weeks, and you can see I made something down there. We'll take a look at it a little while. But the teacher said, if you have, I talked a little about it in the last video, about that here with my lathe here, and also I have an idea, an angle plate here, to make an angle plate, and then mill the, first weld it together, and then mill it straight. But that we haven't gotten to yet. But he said, if I had some projects to make something instead of just sit and weld two pieces of metal together. So I thought about what can I think of, and then it struck me. In my boat, I always have a plastic bottle with drinking water in. So I thought, could I make a tank to fresh water, drinking water, to my boat? And I made drawings and everything and took it with down there. And he thought it was a good idea. And see, it is here. It's made in stainless steel. So that was much. That was instead of sit and weld two pieces of metal together, and then make something that you listen. You concentrate more when it's something here. When I have cut it all the pieces, that then you have to go do it right, because it's not. When you sit just two pieces, oh, that was not, then you just take two new. But I made this one, it's not finished yet, but we'll take a look at it. But it was really fun. I have not so much video, I have a few clips, they're not the best, but there's so much going on down there. So I'll try to see if I can get a little more down there. But I think I'll put these few clips I have in. But let's take a look at what I have made. Here it is. it's made of 2 millimeter thick stainless steel, so it will hold forever. So, but I have made that, and I have also these dots here. It was just a second. The dots here are just some pipe connection in stainless here, but I have turned them down, drilled a hole here, and then turned a little collar on it here, so they fit in here. And then I also turned them. That I did on a lathe. They have a lathe down there. It's not very precise, but. When you have to learn to weld two, let's say that's 1 centimeter thick pipe here together, then you turn, I think it was a 30 degree angle on both sides, and then you hold them together and fill that up here to weld them together. So they have an old coal chest, I think it was, and they're really old. It's not precise in any way, but it's good to make this here. But it's working. And I used that relate to, it was real fun, because when you turn on there's that handle down there, just like Adam, you have, it's not when I, same as I turn my little lathe on, there's really some power behind the lathe like that. But that was a side trip. But I turned a little collar on here, and then I put it in and also turned it down. And then I have welded it all the way around here. And also these edges here, I also welded. I'm a little pleased with it here. And here, it. I have something here, let's see, that one here, so you can see how much water there is in it. It's maybe a little too short, but you can get them longer, but that one's sitting down here, and then here, that is to the air can get out of it. And here I have a pipe in it that goes down to the bottom. It will sit like that in the boat, and then the hull of the boat comes up here. That's why I have that angle here. So I have tried to polish it a little. I don't know if I'll polish it a little more. So, but I got homework. I want to have it so I can get into it. It's for drinking water that should be into it. So when it has been standing a whole winter, I want to have so I can get a hand in here and clean it. So they will burn a plate here to me. I don't know if maybe I can film that. Let's see, to the lid here. I think it was 4 millimeter thick stainless plate. They will make a lid to it. But my homework is to make. I could weld some studs in here, but I think I'll try to make some brass studs here sticking up, and then something to screw them on here, so it look a little nice. It was standing down on the table down there, so everyone could see it. There were many looking at it. So I think I'll try to see if I can't make it nice here, nice lid to it. Maybe polish it a little more up and then see what they say to it. But it was fun to make, really fun to make something that could be used. So let's see what I can figure out here and make to this lid. Okay, I'll try to see if I can film some of when I make the arc. I have a setup here. I'll show you in a little while what I'm working on. I have that little stud there to weld on that piece of. I'll just stand in here then on that little piece of pipe here. But to protect the welding inside, I have made this setup here. You can see here I have let's take a little look over here first. Here I have a piece of pipe with a hose on, and then I put that in the vise here. Yeah. I have turned the little shoulder on here. I will not use this one, it's just to set up here. And then I put that one down there. And then you can have a look. Here I have my argon regulation. Where do I have my torch? You can see. Yeah. When I press it. That's the argon I have on the torch. And then that hose here, you can see here, that run into that tube, and then I just put a good flow of argon in the tube. You can see, we go down there. Now I can feel it up here. The argon is flowing inside the tube. So there. So now the argon in the tube here, and then I'll try to weld it here, because that protected that. Now when that argon is flowing in the tube, there should not be any oxygen in here. That's what spoils the welds. So let's try that. But what I have thought of is to, I have some 8 millimeter brass rod here, and then turn it down some place down here, a bit down here, and then drill to a 6 millimeter, and then drill a 6 millimeter hole, and then put it in, and then thread it up here 8 millimeter, and then put a knot on it here, maybe a little Loctite on it or something. So there will be 8 studs sticking up here. But first, and then a screw here. I have made a few of them, but I'll show you what I have thought of to screw it down. First I face it off here, and then I go a little back here. Now I just push on that button there, and then turn on it there, and then go out here, and then in, and just let it rest. Now we can go a little there, and then that. I hope you can see that. And then I zero out here. Zero. And then you can just go up here again. There. And then I go back here. And then I go 20 millimeter in here and make it 19 and a half millimeter thick. Yeah, let's do that. I've done it 7 times before. I hope I do it right, but I go in here and not far in, not the whole wheel, and then I go in so it rests there. So the wheel is on center, down, just down here and just down here, and then I tighten them up there a little, and I hope you can see. As you can see, so I just go a few rounds here by hand here, and I tight it pretty tight here. So, and then I hope you can hear it. And then I tight it a little more. When the chuck is spinning, and then I put it in a real, real slow feed in. That seems to make a reasonable knurl. So let's try that. See there, and then I go so I can see. feed on. And I feed it really slow that way now. But you can see, I'm not sure. You can see it wobbling a little bit down there. Well, it's a cheap Chinese one, but it seems to do the job. Have a look at it. There. I had a little chips in it. But I think that could be working. So, the next thing. But here it is. I think it working. I do it so. Just a little, not much, but just a little here. Remember it a little here. So, I think that's working. But I want, you can see, I have put, that's maybe not easy, but you have to trust me. The compound here is sitting now in 30 degrees. 30, yes, that must be right. So, now I put my tool in here. Yes, and then I put it in there and get hold of the seat. And then I go. So let's go over there. Oh, maybe we should go there. And then I go in here. That's again that bit to make them eight that are alike. But I go in and then I go in. Let's see. I have put the tool maybe a little further out so it's almost pointing directly in there, like so. And then I go back. Let's go scratch it there. There. Where I have that I have not knurled here, and then I go in and touch it, and just a second, and then I take my indicator here and put it on there. So it sits there. I would like it to point a little up there. So there. Yes. And then I call that zero. Can you see it up there? Where I touch it here in that I call zero. And then I can go a little back here so I'm not scratching it. And then I go out to the edge. Check there, and then back to zero again. And I just have to go there. Now it is just pointing in Oh, maybe you can see it there. I go up, so it's just touching the edge here. And then I have done with all eight. And then I lock the carriage here. Yeah. So now I can. Now I have zero here, down here. Let's see, we can get that. So now I move that in 30 degree. So I'll go 2.5 millimeter in, and then I have done with all eight. So let's do that. Like so, that I have done with all eight of them. So now we have a 30 degree angle here. You see, I have a division here. I can measure how long, far I go out and in. As in other lathes also. But just to make it the same every time. You see, when I have my handle down here, I could also use this one here, but I think that he is working. Here, the handle is down. And then I look in here, I start with 10. And then I go 10 millimeter in. It's taken 2 millimeters per revolution, yeah. So, but I only go here to that. That's 10 millimeter, and then I take 11 millimeter, a half turn here on the wheel here. That I have done with all seven of them. So let's do that. Now I have put the drill in, and then I go back to 10, and then up and touch, and there, then a little back, and then I drill.
not necessarily about it. So that's why I hear it just a little bit. I know it's not necessarily the crash, but now you can see here that was 10 millimeters and then 11 millimeters up here and then
so now I have the same depth in all 8. I take this one thing also to get the same. Let's go a little in here. See, I have my hand down here and then touch, lock, and a little back. One millimeter, a half revolution here on. So now that's also the same. And here I have an 8 millimeter tip. Here. Yeah. I have to go a little back here. So. So now I'll go out in my saw and cut it off. Okay, you can see everything is on the saw now, what I have made the last long time. My vise is on the saw and that up here with the cooling water. I know it's not necessary here with brass, but I want to try and use it. So. I have cut a few, so it's working. And you see, I make that stop here, to so they are the same. So now I can put it. I put it in. Nice there. I just didn't go over here. So can you see? I hope you can see. I put it in the vise there, and then I tighten it. And then I begin to have a short piece of brass there, so I just support it a little here and then I'm sure that it's in there and there. So now it's really working really fine, this here with my mice. That could be maybe a little, but when it begin to be shorter, that piece that would be a little difficult to hold it, but it's working. Let's put some water on. You can maybe see something. I hope yes. You remember I talked about that I have to beware of that I stop the saw before it go down in my vise here. But I have made that stop here longer. It's not stopping the saw. Yeah, all the electrical stop, but it stops the saw so it don't cut in the down in here in the vise. So let's put, now we open here. I hope you can have it. I have it all in the frame. And the light here, that's also fine. So there, now I can adjust how much water I want on both of them. And here, you see, I can give it a little less or a little more. I have some place around there. And then, loosen here. And then, let's go a little down before we start it. There. And then we start. See that now it's close, but it is not cutting in the saw, the vise. Okay, let's see. But here they are, all eight of them. Let's try to put them like so. I think that could look nice. Oh, there should be one more than this. So, I think that could work, and not with a hole in, so the stud is coming up here, and that will not be so long that it will go through. But the next, but I think when my saw is actually cutting it, when I do that, it's pretty precise, you can see, that's pretty. Same thickness they are. So now I have to figure it out what to make a setup so I can cut them, face them off here, and then just touch the edge here. But that I also have to think a little up because I want them to be the same. So let's see what I figure out. That was actually not so difficult because I put a piece of all thread in here and then I just screw it on here like so, and then I have locked everything except the cross light, and then we just take it out. If I do that with all eight of them, then they have to be the same. Now I want to make a chamfer on it. And then I also want to be the same. So I have done it so, I use this setup here again. Tied it on there. And then I have put the compound in the 45 degree angle. And then I have my indicator here. And then I go back 1 millimeter. Oh, that was the wrong way. That's zero and there. Back 1 millimeter. And then I make a cut. Made. I like this here. See, they are the same. So, get one off here. Try and see if you can see them here. So, oh, they are there. So, I think that could be fine. And then with the plate on it. So, now we have to make 8 studs here, but I think that could look nice.